This lesson will cover many of the significant changes to Chapter 3 of the 2020 NEC. The way the NEC is set up, Chapter 3 forms the second of three sequential chapters. You could view Chapters 2, 3, and 4 as the essential how-to chapters of the NEC. Taken together, these three chapters provide the general rules and guidelines that apply in nearly every situation. Chapter 3 gives the explicit requirements for installation of a safe and reliable electrical infrastructure to serve its design purpose. This is one of the reasons Chapter 3 is one of the longest in the NEC, and these basic building blocks and methods of installation have served the industry well for decades. Many of these basic methods are going to be adapted to new purposes without great changes to the installation methods employed. Overall, we'll be covering 23 changes to Chapter 3. Remember that the NEC is designed with an overall structure that moves from the general to the specific. If you've taken one of our courses, you'll remember that Chapter 3 is what I like to call the build chapter. Chapter 2 was plan, and Chapter 4 is use. There are many key topics covered within Chapter 3. Just to highlight a few, it is the chapter where we find information on types of conductors, how they're to be used, and their ampacity thresholds for different sizes and types. This chapter also covers several wiring methods, their uses permitted and not permitted, and many other specific requirements to those wiring methods. It also houses the requirements for outlets and junction boxes. So as you can see, this is indeed an important chapter to pay close attention to. So let's look at some of the key changes that occurred for this cycle.